My name is Jaymee Haefner. I am the harp instructor and the director of undergraduate studies at the University of North Texas. Concerti are interesting in a lot of ways because you're working right alongside the conductor, very much in equal parts because the conductor's in charge of the orchestra and you have to be with the conductor. Ginastera, he changed the pronunciation of his name during his lifetime, just in the last few years of his life. As we know, he's an Argentinian composer, and not only did he write in an Argentine style for the harp, he used different techniques on the harp. So you'll see knocking on the harp, nail glisses, which we use nail glisses sometimes, but he used them particularly well. Lots of times these effects are coupled with hemiolas and dance-like rhythms. So this is not one of those concerti that's just arpeggios and glisses and frills. It's part of it, but it stretches the harp's identity. By far, the most difficult part about playing is the pedals. And so this concerto takes that and highlights it. There's a whole section in the third movement where I play a string and move the pedal. And so you get, it's almost like a trombone-like effect. So the string is going from being, you know, one length to being a shorter length, and then one length to another shorter length. And every time you hear one of those changes, I'm moving a foot. You don't often hear that on the harp. Trust me, there's a lot of movement that's happening back behind the harp in order to make this piece possible to play. Ginastera wrote in such a way that the notes are always overlapping each other. Every time you pluck a string, it continues to vibrate until you stop it. And so it's like a minefield. As you go up the harp and then back down those same strings, they're all vibrating, so you have to hit each one just exactly right. This piece, I think, really parallels the harp's journey in many ways. Dedicating the performance certainly to my family. You aren't just one person, you are the people around you. And secondly, I'd like to dedicate it to my students as well. And students don't always realize it, but they make us better teachers and better players every single day. And I'm continually grateful for that relationship. It's part of the reason that I love teaching as much as I do.